Greetings. Thank you for tuning in for this recital, and I'd like to thank the Hymn Society for its invitation to perform. The program, as you know, is music that has been written by African-American composers. All of the music is by African-American composers, some from Africa who have moved to this country, and of course, citizens of the United States. There is a big resurgence now in locating music and performing music by African-American composers, which actually began in the mid-90s. And we're grateful to Morningstar Music and Dr. Charles Terry for many of the volumes that have been published, for our own Dr. James Abington, who has three wonderful volumes, and I will be playing a number of selections from those, as well as other composers. A lot of these composers never saw their music published. They died, as you see, before it was published. So when their music was performed, it was performed from manuscripts. So we no longer have to do that and are very grateful. Within the music, though, a lot of the composers gave specific instructions for dynamics, for registration, that's the different sounds that you will hear. They also were very advanced in their writing. And so some of the writing that you will hear occurred in the 70s, 80s, and 90s stylistically, but they had done it in the 40s and 50s as far as harmony, as far as dissonance, clusters, all kinds of sounds that will sound strange, which are not me, but the composer. I will share with you from time to time today some comments about some of the music, but you will see that there are spirituals, hymns, as well as freestyle organ music. Enjoy this performance. Roy Belfield is minister of music at Hampton Baptist Church in Virginia, in Hampton, Virginia. He has also been a presenter at one of our conferences for the Hymn Society. The piece I'm going to play, Great is Thy Faithfulness, is a brand new piece that he just wrote and sent me the manuscript for last month. And I, along with some other selections that he's written, and I said, I really would like to perform this. The unique part of the performance of this piece is that after I learned it, we corresponded and I had an organ lesson via email with him, and he gave me several suggestions, and I'm very happy and proud to present Great is Thy Faithfulness. There are very few women who composed organ music. You'll probably notice that most of my composers are male, and that is the reason. There are literally a handful of women, and I have included some of them, and will be including others in future recitals. Ruth Norman toured as a concert pianist, mainly performing music written by black classical composers. She's written works for solo piano, organ, chamber ensemble, and choir. One of the influences that you will hear very strongly in this selection is the influence that mysticism and Eastern philosophy had on her. That is reflected in some of the sounds you will hear. Thank you. We are all aware of how spirituals were used to express emotions, joy, sorrow, pain, anticipation, to give directions to the slaves, for the slaves to communicate among themselves. They have always been a very important part of African American culture in worship, as well as in performance. King of Kings uses only the refrain, and the text is, "He is King of Kings, He is Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the first and last, no one works like Him." You hear snippets of the melody throughout the piece, and as the piece progresses, you'll hear that it gets louder, and some of the notes get slower, and those words are King of Kings, as if one is crying out, King of Kings, not King of Kings. A lot of expression and excitement in this piece, found in the collection by Dr. Abington. Florence Price was an award-winning pianist and composer. She was the first African-American woman to have her work, which was a symphony, performed by a symphony, the Chicago Symphony. This piece, Adoration, is very reflective. My final selection needs no introduction, but I wanted to share some words with you. It is We Shall Overcome. I was in high school in the late 60s when the civil rights movement was at its peak. And this song became, of course, the song for the civil rights movement. And I thought that once that was over and we got into the 70s and the 80s, that everything was fine. But as we can see of things that have transpired in our world, things are not fine. And what will it take to overcome? Communication, understanding, sacrifice of one's own desires, but more importantly, a change of heart among all people. Then we will truly overcome.